Hello everyone, welcome. My name is Jess and thank you so much for watching this video. I want to thank everyone who's been watching my videos and leaving such positive, supportive comments and questions. I really, really appreciate it and I really enjoy connecting with all of you, so thank you. I've been receiving a lot of questions, really, really good questions, and I know that the guides want to address some of them, so I'll eventually, hopefully, get around to doing more like Q&A style videos with some of your questions from the comments. So if the guides want to expand upon any of your questions, I'll kind of throw that all into a video. So if you do have any questions, go ahead and leave them in the comments, or if you want me to expand upon something, you can ask away and I'll ask the guides if they want to expand upon it. So thank you. So first, to start off this video, I want to quickly talk about soul family groups because they're actually going to be referenced a lot in this video. My guides have begun talking about the soul family group of this high vibrational energy known as my guides, or known as the guides. They are not yet ready to disclose themselves, and I know it has a lot to do with me and whether I'm ready to get into that or not, but I know that it's going to happen in the near future, so it'll eventually happen. For now, all you really need to know is that this is a larger soul family group, and many people on the planet are aligned to it, or they integrate the energy. So, also one thing that I want to make clear and I want to note is that the guides that I channel, they're not an entity. So, for example, like Jesus or an angel or something like that, they're not an entity like that. They are more of an energetic vibration on a higher frequency. So they've described themselves as everywhere and nowhere. So when I asked about in terms of where they exist dimensionally, they have stated that they exist everywhere and nowhere. So they can go wherever they want, I'm assuming. I'm not completely sure, but I'll talk more about the guides in another video sometime soon. And of course, I reference them as the guides because they are guiding me. They are guiding so many people on the planet right now. But keep in mind that they are energy. It's an energetic vibration, a higher frequency energetic vibration. I've been told that this channel is going to be able to bring people together within the same soul family group. So people within the same soul family group that is this energetic vibration will begin making connections with other people aligned to the same energy of this guidance system. This is a time right now in which many soul family groups are going to begin coming together and really opening up their gifts. And actually, I remember that I had a recent QHHT session with a fellow QHHT practitioner friend of mine, and when I was under hypnosis, I remember having this vision of soul family groups coming together on the planet, all over the planet. And the reason for this, what came to me in my vision, was because there are certain missions within each soul family group that needs to happen when they're together, I guess, or of some sort. So people within the soul family groups had their roles to play, and the energy within the soul family groups are so much more stronger when people are together, when the same soul family groups are together. So soul family groups are being activated all around the planet, and those people in the same soul family groups are coming together and connecting with each other and working with each other. And I've also been told that connections within soul family groups will be so much stronger in the months and years to come. So keep that in mind whenever you meet someone new or whenever you know someone who you have a very strong connection with, because they're most likely within your same soul family group. Also, with that said, there are many, many, many different soul family groups. There are some larger, some smaller. It all really depends upon what group or groups you most identify with on a soul level. Many people identify with the smaller soul family groups, such as the elemental groups or star family groups. For example, like star family Pleiadians, Arcturians, or Ra, Jesus, etc. But if you think in terms of a funnel, there are the larger groups at the top and then the smaller groups as you filter down. So we're all really part of many, many groups, and we're all essentially part of everything. But again, it's about what do you most identify with? And the guides that I channel and work with are along this larger group that almost everyone on the planet aligns to. And it's this high vibrational, positive frequency energy. And they've told me that the energy of the group is being activated, if not already activated. When talking about this with my guides, because I'm not yet disclosing the names of them to this soul family group, I needed a name in order to move forward referencing our soul family group. And I guess I can just say soul family group, but I wanted to kind of have a distinct name, and I was going to say, okay, our soul family group is a high vibrational soul family group. But then the guides came back and they wanted me to name it the Guilliford Island Soul Family Group. And just bear with me, my guides are kind of this silly, they like to have fun. So I'm allowing them to use me as a vessel and translate their message. So I'm just going to put whatever they want out there. And if they want the Guilliford Island Soul Family Group, then I guess our soul family group is going to be the Guilliford Island Soul Family Group. So until I disclose the names of this energy vibration, we will be the Guilliford Island Soul Family Group. So whenever I move forward saying that, it refers to our soul family group versus any others. And also, if you're watching this video and resonating with the message, you are most likely part of this silly Guilliford Island soul family group. Now, to bring more clarity to the term Guilliford Island, basically, it is a metaphor that my guides like to use often, very, very often. So it's probably good to get used to if you continue following my videos. And I think it started as this playful joke between them and I to describe the new Earth and as this playful way to visualize it. But it's become a very common metaphor they use to describe basically anything of pure bliss. So they define Guilliford Island as absolute delicious bliss and oneness frequency without illusion, knowing that all is truly well. So there you go. In this video, we are the Guilliford Island Soul Family Group. Going forward, my usual disclaimer, please use your own discernment and remember that any timelines or any predictions and information can change. So keep an open mind as we move forward with the messages in this video. Also note that information in this video is channeled information from this higher vibrational Guilliford Island guides. So basically, the information that has come forward is about an upcoming August energy wave at the end of this month. The guides have told me that this is an energy portal that they, the guides, are opening for our soul family group, the Guilliford Island Soul Family Group. And because this soul family group is on such a larger scale, it will affect most of the planet, and everyone is open to it. The reason for this energy wave portal is to help prepare the soul family group for the upcoming event. And this energy wave will also help affect the unmasking of illusion that will come along with the bigger anticipated event in the near future. So all the energetic waves that are coming to the planet right now are affecting the planet in order to A, help upgrade our energy bodies so that we can raise our frequency, but also B, to help expose illusion and really bring light to the darkness. So This video will be about this upcoming Energy Wave portal opening at the end of this month, August. This is a portal of energy for people in our Guilliford Island Soul Family group, but also on a side note, I do want to let you know that other information came through along with this information. So the guides talked about a new timeline for the upcoming event, which I'm going to be talking about in a different video. I'll put that out soon, but I don't want you to get too confused by me incorporating everything all in one video. So keep in mind that the energy wave portal that I'm talking about in this video is not the event. Okay, so the guides came to me this past weekend and they told me that this energy wave portal is about integrating the reality of oneness frequency into the minds of our soul family group and helping to prepare us for the upcoming event. The guide said, "We are opening up a portal in a few days. Efficiently brings energetic upgrade to Guilliford Island Soul Family Group on planet Earth." And they described that it would be purely energetical. Most will not perceive anything, maybe some won't even feel anything, but all in the Soul Family Group will be affected, whether you realize it or not. And they go on to say, "Energy will help Guilliford Island Soul Family Group manifest grand purpose in life. Illusion of 3D Earth disappears, and integration of knowledge about new Earth 5D begins to be activated in energetic structure, efficiently allowing our Guilliford Island Soul Family Group to open higher communication with high vibrational guides, God or Source energy, and higher consciousness in galaxy. Guilliford Island is here, folks." Again, to hammer it into your brain, because it can be a bit confusing if you're like, what is she talking about? Guilliford Island, what does that mean? Guilliford Island is a metaphor that the guides like to use often, very, very often. It started as a playful joke between them and I to describe high frequency bliss, the new Earth, and also to visualize the new Earth. But since then, it's become this really, really common metaphor that they use to describe basically anything of pure bliss, because I now have that reference in my mind. So it's easier for them to just say Guilliford Island, and then I know immediately what they are talking about. They've come to define Guilliford Island as absolute delicious bliss and oneness frequency without illusion, knowing that all is truly well. So they're saying that this energy wave that they're sending, or this portal that they're opening, is a big step for our soul family group into 5D oneness frequency. The portal of energy will be purely energetical, and you don't have to do anything when it comes. There's nothing you need to do to prepare, because you're going to be affected either way. And if they want me to remind you, I'll put out a video the day or so before, but I really don't think you need to worry about it. You'll integrate the energy regardless. And then I asked them, "Is there something or anything we have to worry about or know?" And they said, "No. Guilliford Island Soul Family Group Energy Portal will help those in the Soul Family Group." Go Soul Family Group. They're like cheering us on. "Only effective in Guilliford Island Soul Family Group, because group of souls, including the Guilliford Island Soul Family Group, indeed have connection with each other, because Jess," and they mentioned me, "integrating energy in group." And so I think that they're specifically referring to this channel and the information that I'm putting out, and anyone who receives the information from me, we're like building these connections and activating energies. They go on to say, "Knowledge about New Earth 5D indeed filling soul group with our soul group connection, and soul family sense it in DNA. Activating DNA in soul group. We," they're talking about themselves, "love to see the soul group being activated. central DNA illnesses being cured by activation of dormant DNA strands, not cellular structure. Because when they were talking about the DNA strands, I was thinking about the cellular structure, because they have talked to me about dormant cells in body activating as well. But I guess it's not the cellular structure, but the DNA is being activated through soul group connection and communication for healing. And then they continue to say, Guilford Island efficiently being activated in minds of soul group, illusion of 5D New Earth in minds of many Guilford Island inhabitants. And they're referring to our soul group as the inhabitants of Guilford Island, this just really blissful, absolute delicious oneness frequency without illusion. So imagine just like this amazing island where just anything is possible and everyone is in this oneness frequency. That is Guilford Island. Finally, I know that many people try to confirm things through astrology or aligned cosmic events. So I asked, is this portal of energy aligned with any cosmic event or astrology alignment? And they say no, it's just perfect timing. Illusionary effects in minds of humans on day of portal. Humans efficiently maced in light energy. Humans get maced in face with intense light energy. And this was just a joke. We had a really good laugh at this one because they showed me this vision of people getting maced in the face with just like pure light energy upgrades. And it was hilarious. But basically, what they're saying is that the portal of energy they're opening up is going to be this really strong wave of energy for people in our Guilford Island Soul Family Group. And they go on to say, people face illusions of God, ace God, and face individual illusions efficiently. So it sounds like the energy wave will allow us to face inner illusions, as well as illusions that we may have about God. They said, move over, efficiently, ace, definitely in feminine polygraph. They go on to say, meaning Guilford Island is coming, Guilford Island on way, illusions being exposed soon, get ready. When I see that sentence, efficiently, ace, definitely in feminine polygraph, I think I think that's kind of like them joking about illusions being exposed because of the polygraph. So, and then maybe feminine energy having to do something with divine feminine coming through. I'm not too sure, but sometimes they talk in these weird cryptic like messages, and I don't know if they're joking or not, but take it as you will, and take it with a grain of salt, be open-minded and interpret as you may. And I forgot to mention one thing. So as with any energy upgrade, when you are exposed to high frequency energy, many people are prone to having detox or purging effects, especially if you resonate on the lower frequency levels. So it's like, think about going from a diet of only McDonald's or fast food, and then you jump to a juice only fast. Your body is going to go through this detox, and it might not be pretty. So many of you are purging or releasing old patterns of behavior, emotions, and energy, and it's going to continue to do so as we get closer to the event and following the event. And this can include purging emotionally, mentally, spiritually, physically. It can be anything and everything in your life that needs to go in order to incorporate more higher frequency energy. So if you do notice that you're purging or going through any difficult emotional or challenging times, just try to have compassion for yourself. And sometimes knowing that you're going through this purging process allows you to really hang in there and know that it's going to pass. And for those who are already existing on a higher frequency because you've done your work, you've worked through your stuff, it's possible for further purging, of course, if it's needed, but you may also just start integrating more and more high frequency energy going forward. And really, that's all I have about this energy wave portal coming soon. So get ready, but you don't really have to do anything to get ready. Just be who you are. Thank you so much for watching this video and putting up with all these seemingly cryptic but playful messages that come through the guides. They also want to remind you that the messages are not as important as the frequency of the messages via my voice that comes through the video. I've had so many people get in contact with me saying that just by listening to the videos, they're being triggered with even more knowledge and information that resonates within them. And it's like something opens up within them that allows them to gain deeper knowledge through their own inner access just by listening. So it's like just by listening, it helps you to activate memory on a cellular level, and it triggers knowledge awareness within you so that you can resonate with and access the deeper knowledge that you hold within yourself. And I know that sounds confusing, but basically, don't worry about if you understand the messages or not. You're integrating them on a much deeper level. And through that integration will come deeper awareness and understanding. And when the guides told me this, it took a lot of pressure off for me to perfect my videos, knowing that everything is happening on an energetic level. And so that kind of made things easier to get the messages out. So you just have to be who you are, and you are affecting everyone around you. And I'm beginning to realize and recognize this more and more and more each day. We are all in this together. So thank you so much for listening, and I'll see you in the next video.